They only talk to her because she looks like a total prostitute, okay?
I mean, her butt is just so big. I can't believe it's just so round and out there. I mean, gross. Look, she's just so flat.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny. And when a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and a round thing in your face, you get sprung.
All right, you heard it. Butts. That's what I'm into today. Pork butts it's going to be on the smoker. Can't wait. It's going to be a long process. We're going to get it going. I'm going to season it up and we'll show you how it's done. Stick around.
I was walking with the ghost.
Here we have it. We have a pork shoulder butt roast from Smithfield. It is a nice looking, good size pork butt. We are sitting at about 8.165 pounds. It was on sale for 99 cents a pound. I got it for $8.06. I couldn't pass it up. Great deal. About half price, maybe even better. So we got a big fat cap here. I'm going to trim some of that off just a little bit, I think. Maybe not a whole lot. As fat as flavor. And then I have some rub. I'm going to use my own homemade rub. And I have some honey sriracha rub I'm going to put on there. We're going to let it sit for a while before we put it on the smoker. All right, so we're going to cut her open. I put some tin foil down, try not to make a big, huge mess. There's plenty of blood inside of this package, so I know it's going to happen. But that's all right. I'm going to pull this out of here. I'm going to blot down some of the moisture off of this butt. Try to get it dried a little bit. All right, so I'm just going to take a paper towel. Just kind of blot it off there a little bit. It's a little slippery on this tin foil, but I expected that. Pretty good size hunk of meat. A lot of good marbling in here, which I like. It's really good. You can see that a little better. Like that. Some good marbling. It's got a good bone right there. It's not bad for a little over $8. Okay, so once I get this off of here, I'm gonna take a look and see if there's anything on here I want to trim off. See, I got some of this fat just kind of popping up and just a little extra, more than I need. I'll trim a little bit of that off. Not a lot, because it's kind of not real bad anyway. I don't normally trim a lot of fat off of a pork butt, but a little bit. Get a little bit off the back side here. Blow a little bit more of that off there. Well, the fat cap isn't too thick, really. A little bit right here, but not much. You know, they say, I don't know, quarter inch thick fat is plenty. I probably got a little bit more than that. See, I'm already down to meat there, so I'm not going to take much off of it. That don't look too bad. Okay, so. Alright, so what I'm going to put on now is some of my rub. This is my homemade rub. It's, I like to call it Angry Bird. It goes really well on wings. It's got a kick to it. It's paprika, some garlic, some salt, pepper, a little onion powder. Few other spices. It's been really good to me, so I'm gonna go ahead and load this on fairly good. Pat it in. Put it up on the side like so. Get some on the sides. Smells really good too. Really like this rub a lot. course, this side, all the way around. Don't be too shy. We're gonna let it sit overnight. Probably gonna sit for 12, 14 hours. Not everybody does that. A lot of people throw it on and, you know, let it sit for 20 minutes, half an hour, and then that's enough. All right, so I've got this sitting in this wrap for 12, 13 hours. I'm gonna go ahead and take this wrap off. And I got the smoker coming up to temp as we speak. While it's doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and throw on a little bit of this sriracha honey, or honey sriracha seasoning. I'm just gonna put it right on top like this. All around the whole thing, all four sides. So get it on there good, pat it down. You can see leaving it in there, I kind of lost some of my seasoning on this saran wrap, which I know it's gonna draw a lot of moisture out because there's salt in these seasonings, and that happens. All right. All right, so I'll be back in just a minute. All right, a little close-up look of the pork butt with all the rub on it. Looks good, it's good, got really good color. I like the way it looks. It's kind of moist, it looks like it's in there real well. I got my smoker coming up to about 225 for a temperature. I got the hopper filled with apple pellets. So we're gonna go with the apple flavor. I'm gonna put it in. Stick it right. Fat side up, like so. Right there. Holy, look at that, looks so freaking good. About halfway through, I can't wait to get into this bad boy. All right, so I am about 8 hours in on this pork butt, and I just want to give a quick recap, take a look at what we got going. Hey, look at that beautiful bark. That looks totally amazing. I haven't even sprayed it, but I don't think I need to. It looks really tender, looks really good and moist. So I'm gonna keep rolling till I hit 165. Then we're gonna wrap it up. Okay, so the long-awaited 13 hours for it to get up to my temperature. I'm sitting at 167. I was hoping to pull it 165, 167 is good. So I'm gonna pull it out, put it in this tin. We're gonna wrap it up, put a few things on it, and we're gonna put it back in until it reaches 205. Holy moly, it's already so soft. Well, we'll take it in, wrap it up, and be right back. All right, so let's have a good look. So, set it down like that. Whew, boy, that looks so good. Pour a little bit on just like this. Don't have to be a lot because it'll spread all over. That's probably plenty. Butter and a little honey. Just like that. Now I got this double wrapped. I got two pieces of thick, heavy duty tinfoil. Have to wrap it up better now. Try to wrap it up all the way. That'll work. That way you have it on there completely covered. And then I'll poke my probe in there as well. We're gonna put it back on until it hits 210 temperature internal. Okay, let's take it back out. All right,
so I realize there's no light out here. 8:30 at night. I don't have an outside light, so I'm just gonna throw it on here like this. You're not gonna see much. Pop my probe back inside. About like that. All right, so it says 203. I've seen it click between 203 and 205 a few times, so I'm gonna call that good. I'm gonna pull it off, we're gonna wrap it up, and we're gonna let it rest in the cooler for at least an hour. So let's get it wrapped up and take it inside.
All right, so it's in the pit, in the tin pan. I'm gonna leave it wrapped. I don't know if you can see it, but there is juice coming out of that tin. Super hot, super juicy. So now I put a couple holes in the tin where I put the probe. So I'm gonna put it on this tin foil. I'm gonna wrap it up in tin foil one more time. Then I'm gonna wrap it up in this towel. Try to keep the moisture inside so I don't get the towel ruined. Basically trying to protect the towel a little bit. So I'm gonna wrap it in here. Wrap it up real good. Like so. Okay, and then I got this towel wrapped up. I've got this cooler here. Brand new cooler. Basically, I bought it just for this today. I'm gonna stick it inside here. And let it rest for at least an hour. In about an hour or so, we will come check it out. We'll open it up. We'll see how tender it is. We'll take a taste, and we are gonna be super, super happy. Stick around. All right, so we are sitting at just under 2 hours of resting time. It's pushing midnight. I started this process at a little after 7 a.m. Spent 15 hours on the smoker, a couple hours here in the cooler. We're talking 17 hour deal here. It's not a fast process. So let's take it out of here. It is really hot still. This towel is burning up. Set this over here. I'm gonna take it out of the towel quick, put it back in the tin pan. We're gonna break it up.
check it out. Put my tin over here. She's warm, folks. All right, so I'm gonna put on my rubber gloves with, I got some cotton gloves underneath the rubber gloves to keep my fingers from getting burnt real bad, and we'll open it up. All right, so take it out of here. Like I said, it's super hot. Even though it's been sitting a couple hours, still, wow, that looks awesome. Let's dump it right out in here. Lots of juice, love the juice. Amazing. Get this out of our way. I mean, I don't know how well you can see that. Looks pretty good, but watch how easy this breaks off. Here's that bone. I mean, clean. Bone's clean as a whistle. Ooh-wee. Watch this. Look, it just fall apart. Like nothing. It's exactly what I was looking for. It's what I wanted. Super tender, super hot. That good, beautiful bark on it. Look at that bark. Looks amazing. How well you can see it. Heat it up, break it up. It's not bad with these cotton gloves under here. I can handle it. But boy, look at that. There's a lot of meat there. A lot of dinner. I know it's midnight, but it'll be good for tomorrow. I'm gonna have some right now. We're gonna make a little sandwich, a pulled pork sandwich. And we're gonna do a little bit of taste test. All right, so what I'm gonna do now, because I like my flavor, I'm gonna put some more of my homemade rub. I'm gonna put it over top. Not real super thick, but just another pinch of it just to give it another kick flavor. About like so. Gonna mix that in real good. Boy, I won't lie, this is a long process, but the end result is superb. That looks amazing. I don't know if it gets much better. This piece has got my name on it. Oh boy. Wowzer. Really good. Stick around, we'll make a sandwich. We'll test it out. All right, so we're gonna build a couple sandwiches. I got a couple ballpark buns here. I'm gonna just use this plastic fork and throw it on there. Now, I don't put barbecue sauce on it right away. I let people put that on as they like it. Not everybody likes barbecue sauce. Not everybody likes what I would put on it. So I let them make that choice. Some people like to put it on and that's the way it is. But there's that. I'm gonna put some white American cheese over top. The only thing I'm really missing for this sandwich, honestly, would be some coleslaw. Coleslaw would be perfect for this guy right here. But some American white cheese. And then a little bit of my Jimmy Choo Tangy Iowa Bourbon. This is like a honey mustard. It's going to go really good with this pork. I'm going to use that. Put a little spot on there for each one of them. Like that. All right. Stick around. We'll take a bite. All right, folks. Well, here we have it. A couple pulled pork sandwiches. Jimmy Eats Way. Yeah, I could put a lot more stuff on there to make it more appealing, more, you know, even better, but I don't have all that stuff. What I got is going to work just fine. I'm going to go ahead and throw the lids on these guys. Tell you what, if you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, right now would be a great time to do that. Hit the notification so you don't miss anything. By all means, I like comments and thumbs up, so don't forget about me there. Another quick look. This pork sandwich is
smelling amazing. Let's try it out. Let's take a bite. Still hot. I won't lie. A little coleslaw, and that would be the best pork sandwich I've ever had. Super amazing. Really good. Fun to do. I mean, I won't lie. If you're not going to dedicate yourself to 15 to 18 hours to do one of these, forget about it. It's a long process, low and slow, 225 degrees, all the way till I hit 165 internal, wrap it up, put my stuff on there, my brown sugar, my honey, all that, and then it goes on again. I did bump it up to 250 until I hit 203 to 205. Then I let it rest for a couple hours. So it was a very long process. Not something that I love to do because, you know, I'm hungry. I don't like to wait 15, 18 hours for my supper. My kids, they probably don't like to either. But hey, you know, it's what it is. You kind of got to start it real early in the morning or late at night and go all over through the night so it's ready for the next day. It's just one of them things. But I'll tell you what, I love it. The outcome on this long process is to die for. You can't complain. If you love this kind of stuff, let me know. Throw me some comments. Hit me up down in the bottom in the comments, by all means. You know, I tell you what, man. I get to doing this, and this keeps looking at me. I tell you what, with that being said, I'm Jimmy Eats, and that's just what I'm going to do. I'm gonna eat. Thanks. You have a great night.